24 hours ago, there would have been 10 feet of water where I'm standing. Tonight, the floodwaters from Sandy have finally receded. However, you're seeing sights that you wouldn't typically see, like this boat in the middle of the roadway, and communities throughout Long Island that are still in the dark. Heartbreak and devastation all along the south shore of Long Island.
We need help down here too. Let's not make it another Katrina or New Orleans. And, you know, let the people who don't have a lot, you know, be the last.
That's what residents in Broad Channel, Queens feared as first responders passed by, continuing to head south. It wouldn't be until 8 p.m. until we saw where they were going. This is something you would never expect to see in Queens. Streets that are nearly impassable. As you can see, electrical wires are strung across the roadways and the roads covered in a half inch of mud and debris. Ambulances line the roadway, helping the evacuation process. And as you look on the other side of the street, about five blocks worth of homes and businesses just left to burn 24 hours after Sandy made landfall. This man lost his Rockaway business, first by water, then fire.
There's two stories above it with tenants. I'm just wondering if everyone got out safely.
So you don't even know if your tenants are accounted for?
We don't know if the tenants are accounted for, no. We haven't heard anything.
Back in Broad Channel, for those who didn't evacuate, they had to sit and watch the waters rise.
A rope, we were going to tie it to ourselves and go to the next house, because if that would have came through our house, we saw 8 or 9 30-foot boats come right down the street here.
When you saw the water coming up these stairs, what'd you think?
We only got one more floor to go.
A lot of the residents I spoke with are determined to rebuild and return to all communities throughout the five boroughs. I'll be following this story throughout the remainder of the overnight and through the day tomorrow. Reporting in Queens, meteorologist Chris Gloninger, CBS 6 News.